color 1/3 of this page in yellow. Psh, that's so easy.
Oh my god!
What did you do that for?
You don't know how to solve these questions.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't. You have to know how to multiply integers to solve this question.
What does that even have to do with this question? Oh. Wait, what is multiplying integers?
Okay, so the multiplication of integers is to multiply two or more whole numbers, which can either be positive, negative, or zero.
Can you show me how?
Sure, come here.
So first, we'll start off with two positive integers, like 3 times 8.
Oh, I see. Aha! It equals positive 24.
So in this example, 3 times 8 is 24. What did you find?
Well, when we're multiplying two positive integers, the answer will be a positive integer too.
Yes, you should know that since grade 4, I believe.
Oh, psh, whatever.
Now, if we change the 3 and 8 to negative numbers, it will be negative 3 times negative 8.
Oh, so it will equal negative 24?
Actually, no. When there are negative integers, it gets more confusing. When there are two negative integers in this multiplication, the two negative signs actually cancel each other.
Oh, okay, so then negative 3 times negative 8 equals positive 24?
Correct. When we are multiplying two negative integers, the answer will be positive.
Oh, what happens if there's one negative integer and one positive integer? What happens if there are more than two integers in this multiplication?
If there is one negative integer and one positive integer, the negative sign won't be canceled. For example,
hey!
Negative 3 times positive 8 will carry down the negative sign. And we can put plus 8 in the first bracket. Oh my god, this is confusing.
I told you not to put that. Let me teach you this lesson.
Fine.
Okay, here's the trick. When you have one negative integer and one positive integer, the answer will always be a negative. So, negative 3 times positive 8 equals negative 24, not positive.
But how does this even relate to real life?
It definitely relates to real life because like when we are doing some financial situations, you know, it definitely does.
Can you give me an example? I barely understand what you're saying.
I don't know. I'm sorry. I can't help you.
What?
I can't. I can't.
That's not fair. That was an ideal. Oh, how am I supposed to figure this out? How does this relate to real life?
It definitely relates to real life when we are calculating financial situations, like, you know, like money and stuff.
Can you give me an example? I don't even know what you're saying.
Sorry, I don't know. I can't help you with it. I'm sorry.
What? That wasn't your plan. Where are you going?
I'm sorry.
Oh,
I'm so confused.
Hi, do you need any help?
Yeah, I don't know how to do a real life example for multiplying integers.
Okay. Let's say your friend Bob has been borrowing money from you for 5 days in a row. He has been borrowing money for $6 a day. How much money did you lose by the end of the week? So that would equal negative 30. 5 positive 5 times negative 6 equals negative 30. So you lost $30.